A year ago, prompt engineering was the hottest job in AI. People were earning insane salaries just for writing clever prompts. Then the conversation shifted to context engineering with retrieval pipelines, vector databases, and memory tricks. Eventually, this will fade away too and will give way to automated workflow architecture powered by LLMs. In this video, I'll walk you through why prompt engineering is dead, and how context engineering is already hitting its limits, and what is replacing them. Let's dive in. Prompt engineering rose because early LLMs were fragile. Tiny changes in phrasing could break an answer. That is why we saw viral tricks like act as an expert, explain like I'm 5 years old. Remember when Google first launched? Some people were search ninjas, stacking Boolean operators and quotation marks. They felt powerful because they knew the tricks. But then Google got smarter, and that skill faded into the background. Prompt engineering was the same. It worked, but sometimes it didn't. It was fragile, where small changes in model versions broke prompt. Every new feature meant more prompt variations. And at the end of the day, LLMs predict text, not logic. Now we are past prompt engineering. The models are stronger in itself. Most of the time, precise query with clarity will fetch you an answer without any prompting hacks. Look at the new OpenAI playground. The old system, message box, it is gone now. Now it is a developer message where you can describe the model's role, tone, and rules. Below that, you have got prompt messages, the actual user queries. The playground gives structured control. And with features like developer messages, variables, tools, and memory, you can design workflows without hacking prompts. The models itself are evolving and getting stronger, even without setting the persona and rules. They're moving towards precision and accuracy. I'm not saying prompt engineering is completely useless now. Not at all. For example, think about researchers fine-tuning a model for medical use. A sloppy prompt could literally risk giving unsafe advice, so they designed precise prompt templates that ensure consistency across thousands of cases. However, in the future, this capability will be inherently built into evolving models. The role of prompting hacks has significantly evolved, and their necessity has generally reduced with GPT-5 compared to GPT-3.5 and GPT-4. GPT-5 is designed to be more intuitive, intelligent, and capable of deeper reasoning, which changes how you interact with it to get optimal results. GPT-3.5 required techniques like verbose role-playing, extensive few-shot examples, and strict formatting keywords, whereas in GPT-5, the model handles ambiguity and intent better. Focus shift from hacking the model to coaching or managing it. GPT-5 is better at following multi-step requests, coordinating with tools, and retaining context across turns. GPT-5 has an internal thinking mode that often applies sophisticated reasoning like tree of thought automatically. The need for let's think step by step has reduced, but still useful to force deeper reasoning, not denying that. Now we are in the age of context engineering. Instead of just clever wording, we started feeding models more information through system prompts, setting up personas and tones, RAG pipelines, vector databases. This meant pulling relevant documents from databases with the help of RAG, structuring your inputs with JSON or markdowns and templates. And we give system prompts to shape tone and persona. But context engineering has its own limitations. Manual curation became endless. Let's say if database schemas are changed, you have to rewrite summaries or instructions for the model. Scaling caused conflicts and redundancy because the more the business evolves, the more engineers have to curate and recurate the context. In addition to that, larger context windows slowed everything down and made debugging a nightmare. For a prototype, it is fine. But in real business systems with dozens of workflows and changing regulations, it quickly becomes unmanageable. So when you try to run AI at real business scale with compliance rules, constantly changing data, and dozens of workflows, you can't afford handcrafted prompts and manual contexts. The future is not prompts or context. The future is workflow architecture. So if prompts and context are fading, what is replacing them? It is clear thinking. The AI mirrors your clarity. If you give a vague question, you will get a vague answer. A precise question will get a precise answer. Domain expertise matters any day. A lawyer drafting contracts with AI beats someone pasting act as a lawyer. A real programmer beats someone with fancy copy-paste prompts any day. Workflow architecture is crucial now. Instead of hand-feeding prompts, systems generate and deliver context automatically. Code examines databases, generates schemas, and feeds relevant information to the model at each step. Outputs are not just from training data. They are validated against schemas. So this is the real shift from prompt engineering to context engineering to automated workflow design. Every technology goes through the hype cycle. Same is going to be with AI. The value has shifted from knowing the perfect prompt to knowing how to build workflows that solve real problems. So yes, prompt engineering is dead, and context engineering is already showing its limitations. The real skill now is workflow architecture. Designing systems where context, instructions, and outputs are generated and validated automatically with no human intervention. That is where the future is headed, and it is not just hype, it is preparation. Now I want to hear from you. Do you think prompt engineering is truly dead or just evolving? Drop your thoughts in the comments and we'll talk about it.